I am fucking knackered. You know when you just stand there, you just debate, what are you doing? And you think, oh, I can't remember what I'm doing. What was I doing? I've come down here for a reason. I don't know why I've come down here. It's that type of morning for me right now. I'm feeling fucking knackered. Anyway, welcome to today's video. I don't have no idea why I just told you that. I don't even know why I started off that video with that. But welcome to today's video. It's the 11th of January. It's 11 days into fucking January. I remember waiting for the countdown in New Year. Now it's 11 days later. Is it me or is it going quick? I feel like it's going quick this year already, which is not good. I found out the older I get, the quicker life goes. I remember being at school and I couldn't wait for the day to end and get home. That your day used to be so long, but now the day's over. I'm like, fuck, I didn't even get to do half the shit I wanted to do. Why am I waffling? Anyway, welcome to today's video. No idea what it is. Might be like a full day of eating, might be like a cheat day. I have no idea. But I hope that you enjoy. Sit back, relax, as always. Make sure you like the fucking video. Like it because it looks better on when someone searches me. If anyone actually searches me. Anyway, meal number one. See what we got. So I went to Co-op quickly and picked up a few bits which I'm willing to try in my breakfast. Picked up some fruit or sliced fruit loaf, which I'm a fan of. I don't know why, I've just got that sweet tooth about me now. I think raisins, get in my belly. Got myself some cheese. Co-op basic though, unfortunately. And then I've got myself some baked beans. Beans mean Heinz. No added sugar, of course, because yeah, bodybuilder, bro. And then also, get off. Some mini eggs. As Easter's coming up, I fucking love some mini eggs. I'm just gonna nibble on these throughout the day. Bam, 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 bam!
Seven regions. It's a very big contract to take on by two very big players.
And then the magic is where we're gonna add some cheese. Love cheese. Absolutely. I'd just probably go through that whole entire packet myself and just eat it. Absolutely love cheese. There we go, bit like that, and then we're gonna get our egg. Now this is gonna be risky, Georgie boy, but we'll take risks in life. Just about. We're gonna place that on top like that. Beautiful. And that, my friends, is what meal number one looks like. I only got one egg because I ran out of eggs and just typical one was left. Got some cheese, some beans, a bagel. Then we've got that sliced loaf or sliced fruit loaf, whatever you want to call it. And we've got some salmon on top of it. Someone in my recent video said, oh, George, you eat raw salmon. That's disgusting. It's not raw salmon. It's smoked salmon. It's ready cooked salmon you can use. Dear Lord. That's what it looks like. Macros hopefully will be on the screen if I can calculate that. But I'll do my best as always. And it's none for you. Yes, you. Look at you. None for you. You look sad, boy.
As a mere, might as well just give you a taste test. What am I gonna try first? I'm actually gonna try. Fuck's sake. Oh, great. Oh, that was a bloody disaster. First thing I am gonna try, probably the cheese and the beans. This one here, what it looks like, my friends. Oh God, it's all full. That was a bad move. That was a really bad move. Good, but it's spilling everywhere, for fuck's sake. The addition to the cheese added makes a huge difference. Big fan. I'm gonna leave that for a second and quickly taste test. I've never had fruit loaf slices, whatever it's called. I know it's got raisins in it. I'm a big fan of raisins in bread, but if you give me a little packet of raisins, I wouldn't be able to eat them. Weird like that. Very fruity. Very raisiny, if that's a word. Not gonna lie, it's not as good as cinnamon raisin bagels, but I'll still eat it, it's doable.
There's reduced public transport fares.
I cannot tell you how much conversation is going up.
So despite being, what, £25 above stage weight, this fucking dog still walks me. I don't know how to stop him from pulling. He is, when he's less like energetic, he'll stop pulling. But when he's full of energy first thing in the morning, fuck me, does he pull. And he sends me flying. He's got so much power behind him. And I need to put him in his fucking place, I think, right now. You can see me, like, all of a sudden, just fucking, he's so energetic, got so much energy. Look, this is what happens when he sees another dog. He goes fucking skits. I don't know if you can see that up there. There's a few dogs. Ew, boy. Ew.
Just a brief demonstration.
So I really like the old morning walk, especially after eating my meal number one. There's nothing worse than eating your meal and just sitting about and doing fuck all and just feeling lazy, lethargic, tired. So as always, I get up and just move about. It really kind of helps with digestion, just settles my appetite, and especially with the just feeling lethargic and stuff like that, it just helps. Come on, boy, get it. Come on, come on. You ready?
boy.
Yeah, it really does help with almost like treating it like a GDA almost.
A glucose disposal agent. Going for the walk really does help that side of things as well.
But he loves it and he needs walking. I can't seem to get my steps underneath 10,000 at the moment with him in my life, because when he goes for walks, he needs to go for big walks. So I'm doing well over 10,000 steps each day, which is annoying because my body weight will drop and I need to eat more food. And so it's going to get to a point of where I'm going to be on a ridiculous amount of calories trying to get the food in. So I'm going to have to really try and make sure I can get my steps down, because I just don't want to be walking about all my life and eating 10,000 calories of food every single day just because I'm doing 25,000 steps, which I'm not doing, but I'm doing over 10,000, that's for sure.
What you got there? What you got there? What we got here then? Go on.
Good boy. My fucking G. What you got there? Oh, big boy.
Just came to Tesco's to get a few bits and bobs. It's quite funny how on prep I used to park as far away as I possibly could from the shop so I can get my steps in. But now in my off season, I will park as close as I possibly can to the shop, because I don't want to be doing fucking crazy amounts of steps, you know. I don't want to be walking about the rest of my life. I think sometimes you can do too much output in your off season and it's going to take away from your performance in the gym. I'm actually a big believer in that. Now, some people it's really hard to do because obviously your job is very demanding. You're on your steps all day. You might work in retail where you're walking about. Generally, what I would recommend to anyone is just try and minimize that as best as you possibly can. So instead of like walking about non-stop, if there's an opportunity for you to sit down, then just sit down, you know, instead of fucking walking about. But it's weird how your mindset changes. Like when I was in prep, I would park as far as I'd park all the way up there, but now I'm parking right near the fucking shop because I ain't doing any more steps. I tell you, I've already taken a fucking dog for a walk and that was long enough.
Hands down, the best cookies. Please, if you haven't tried these, try them. They are really, really good. As I say, a packet a day keeps the childish look away. Get some of these in your life. So I finally ran out of the cream. Apologies for this entire mess that you see going on here. Probably commenting at me, George lives in a shithole. I'm not. I'm just sorting out my clothes and the missus is going away and I've got a box of just shit here. In all honesty, yeah, I'm living in a bit of a dump right now. But ran out of the old cream of rice and restocked on my favourite. So I got 2.5 kilos of the milk chocolate. In my honest opinion, that is my favourite flavour. Not sure why. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn the sludge. I'm going to make a sludge with the Rule 1 lightly salted caramel protein. And I'm going to make a sludge on top of that. And is those two combos is like chocolate custard. That in there. I'm going to have 100 grams, mate. 100 fucking grams. 85.
So I get a few questions about how I make my protein sludge, and it's quite straightforward. All you simply need to do is get your whey protein, put it in a glass, a bowl, a cup, whatever you want to put it in, and then what you want to do is just put a slight bit of water in. Obviously the more whey protein you use, the more water you're going to have to use. Simple as that. The less you use, less protein, less water. Quite straightforward. Fill that up, and then what you might need to do is what I would suggest is put little in first, then you can add to it instead of putting too much in to begin with, and you've pretty much fucked the sludge up. Then what you start to do is you just start to kind of get around the edges, and then as you can see the texture starts to go a little bit harder. And then again, I'm probably going to need a little bit more, just the tiniest amount, because you can fuck this up and it'll just go like watery, like a protein shake very quickly. Sludgy sludge texture like that. It looks like custard.
Hands down, I'll be totally honest with you, one of the best proteins I've used in a long while. I haven't actually even restocked on my whey protein from Bulk Powders. I haven't even restocked on it because I'm using this because I like it so much. If you're interested, go over to Supplement Mad, use my code George10 and you'll get yourself 10% off any products on there. But that is the final product and that's what it looks like. Added some three grams of table salt onto there, bit of blueberries, beautiful. Absolutely lovely.
So adding into the pre-workout, look at my camera now, there's some stuff going on just here which I'm not sure what, you can't see it, but on my screen there's something which is it even focusing on me? I think so. I'm really struggling. If anyone has a Canon GX7 Mark II or 3, please let me know, because I'm struggling to get this fucking shit to focus on me. Is that even focusing, bruv? Oh, it is. I'm gonna have to edit that bit out. Bit of roid rage for me. Really bunged up still. I've been ill for the past like 3 weeks now. It's doing my fucking head in. Anyway, pre-workout.
oh, cookie, what's the traditional muffin pump, man? And I'm thinking, when you actually look into digesting food, are you actually going to utilize the cookie or the muffin pre-workout? No. I don't get the hype of this fucking muffin or cookie pump pre-workout. Even though I'm having a cookie pre-workout, really contradicting myself here. It's not going to digest by the time you train. Believe me. Very weird how people have that, but I'm going to have a cookie. Taste test. The only issue with this one is they need to go a little stale for like a couple of days. The softer the cookie, the better the cookie. I could have put it in the microwave for about 5 seconds. Me and my mouthful as well is really rude, that I apologise. However, these are very good. And as they say on the packet, expertly baked in store. They are very good. Highly recommend. However, they are a bit too hard for me, so I need to let them go a little stale. Nice. Worst vlog ever.
Right-hand side, Oxford Stadium at 5:30 euro.
Just got to the gym, running the...
You've got 28% battery.
Shock. You always bloody have no battery at all,
no,
do you?
I'm on about my camera. My phone's got 21.
Oh, well, that's better than normally what you have.
Yeah.
Running the Nova Pump Neuro on my push days, chest and arm days, whatever you want to call it. And then I'll keep caffeine on my leg days, and then other days I won't have anything at all. Already gave you like a little review of this. Don't know, do you want any of it, non-stim? Get a live taste test. Obviously, now I can plug on social media, it's great. George 10 for discount. Try it, it's pretty good. Yeah, we were meant to do a taste test, but as you can see, we've drunk it. And
we're just talking away, sipping.
So it must be good if we drunk it, or it could have been really bad and we just actually just not filmed it and just drunk it.
But I don't know the flavour of it, but it tastes like really fruity.
Bomb Pop. No, Snow Cone. Snow Cone reminds me of Monsters, Inc. Waiting for chest and arms. I'm barbell bench pressing, you're in.
I'm hammer strength incline in flat dumbbell, and then I do one shoulder movement because I do push.
Yeah.
So I'll do probably Smith shoulder press and then some accessory work. One chest, one shoulder, then I'll do arms for you.
Yeah.
So I'll jump in with you wherever I can.
So we're just going to go with the flow and see how it goes. Try and beat my. To be fair, my pressing has got better. It's not the best, but try and not be a poverty presser anymore. And just see how it goes. But yeah, we did taste test it, like I've not done it already. I've still got the Jay Cutler one as well, actually, you know.
Jay Cutler?
Jay Cutler's brand.
Where'd you get that from?
AJ gave it to me. Pumps, hydration, Jay Cutler one. You can have that if you want. Don't want it. It's shit. Anyway, yeah, see you in the gym. Sorry, Jay Cutler, didn't mean that. And you can see
my videos.
Yeah. Sorry, Jay. So presses, bit of a nightmare on the barbell bench press. I seem to be stalling that lately, which is really, really fucking pissing me off. I've been stuck on that 100. I just don't know why. Getting to 100 was easy for me, but then surpassing 100 now and trying to beat the what I did previously is just becoming a bit of a nightmare. So barbell bench press was pretty whack. And then obviously with the incline, Smith was okay. Getting a spot, added like 2.5 kilos to each of my top set and back off set.
Same with my Smith machine press as well, added 2.5 to that. We're now doing some fluffy, boring isolation work, which no one really gives a fuck about. But yeah, okay, not happy. You happy?
Very, yeah.
If Nate's happy, I'm happy. Oh, I've done you dirty here, Nate, I tell ya. Come on. Keep in the first four and then edit out the last six.
KFC. What does KFC stand for? Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Bonus banquet, bonus banquet, barbecue wrap.
Hi guys, this is like a...
I feel like I want to fucking put it down already. Carry on,
sorry, you're on it for at least a minute. So KFC, for this week, we're going for something a little bit different because we're so used to our...
Bargain bucket.
Bargain bucket, that's it. See, you can tell I'm not experienced with KFC. No. Anyway. Gone for the...
Gone for the bonus banquet.
Bonus banquet.
Sorry, hold on. Let me actually... On me. Oh, God.
Make an effort.
Okay, right. Oh.
Okay, good.
Stop.
So we've got a bonus banquet. Of course, chips. Chicken strips. Then, of course, gravy, standard. I've then gone for the barbecue wrap. The barbecue wrap. And then I've also... Because three chicken strips isn't enough for George, who is trying to gain some muscle. I've also got an extra two strips, which is quite nice. And then we're finished off with a 7-Up.
Can you not put that on the radiator, please? Because the radiator's on.
Sorry.
You can put it on this wooden thing, but just not on the radiator. Thank you.
Sorry. Okay. Okay, now, see, that's what I...
Do you want me to record you?
See, this is what I part with.
Should I fucking do this?
This is what I part with every day. Taste test, chips.
Huh, well, good thing I turned it off, eh?
Turn it off?
Yep.
So I'm just wasting doing that?
Yep.
Still recording?
Go on, do it again.
Oh.
Silly bastard.
Chips live taste test. Actually, I've made a rookie mistake here. Chips taste test with the...
Do you not put any salt on your chips?
Nah. It's salty enough as it is.
No, they're not. There's no salt on them.
There we go. That was nice. And then chicken strip. I like chicken strips. I like chicken on the bone as much. Take me long to chew, innit?
Yeah, like face the camera when you eat as well.
Is that better? I try rushing the chewing then.
Why?
Just so, because it's not awkward, innit? Because I'm just, the camera's just watching me eat.
Listen, that's why there's an amazing thing called editing. Doesn't really matter what you do. Standard.
That's fucking
it. Open up your beard and show them your real hair.
Oh yeah, for people that don't know. Can you see that?
Yes, oh, fucking hell yeah, you can. Jeez.
I'm a natty blonde. It's growing quick, innit? Look how quick my beard's growing in like 3 weeks. I'm not getting a haircut now until Thursday. So I've got to rock this look for the fucking rest of the week.
I think you should cheat on him.
I look like Lord Farquaad, whatever his name is from fucking...
Farquaad. Farquaad?
The one, I look like the geezer from Shrek.
The midget.
The little midget king bloke.
Yeah, Lord
With his Lord hair like Farquaad. This. Lord Farquaad. That's definitely not it, is it?
I think it's Farquaad. Lord Farquaad.
I thought Lord Farquaad.
No, it's not Lord Farquaad. I know that for sure. Farquaad, yeah.
Lord Farquaad.
Farquaad.
Well, anyway, I look like him. Like that.
This fucking midget. Oh, don't have that in the background.
Jeez.
Midget.
Lord Farquaad.
Farquaad.
Farquaad. Yeah.
Fuck you.
Anyway, I'm going to get on with eating because I've just put my hat back on because fucking hell. Can't have my hair down like that. Oh, we're still recording, are we?
Yeah, man.
Could you just let me eat in peace now? I've said what I've had. KFC. What's going on here? Sometime we buy me a metal one. I actually am now because I'm fucking sick of these.
Yeah.
There's got to be a way they can make these better. That is just...
Babe, metal ones are the way to go. Don't know why, just buy a metal one.
It tastes butters, you know when it tastes butters on your lips?
Yeah.
Oh, fuck that. Anyway, it's 7-Up by the way, because it's free in caffeine. 7-Up free because it's 7...
Because it's free of caffeine. Yes. 7-Up free.
It's free of caffeine, sugar. And you know I don't drink much caffeine anymore.
Hardly any. None.
Hardly any. Anyway, fuck off. I'll see you in a bit.